Ivala Supreme Court CJI Justice N.V. Ramana Padavi Viramana Chenunaru Rajakiya Partila Uchita Hami Rapai Supreme Court Chief Justice N.V. Ramana Tirpu Velvaristunaru Alive Chitta.
That the young and dapper person who is sitting there is now going to retire fully from the judiciary out at a very, very young age. But I won't repeat what I have been saying earlier because it will look like a gramophone with its needle stuck. That this is not the age at which our judges of the Supreme Court should retire. And that's not the age at which the judges of the High Court should also retire. But anyway, that's not within my control. I can only repeat the same thing. But what is outstanding so far as Chief Justice Ramana is concerned is the persuasion with which he was able to clear the areas of the appointment, the vacancies. And I understand that more than 224 vacancies were filled up in the High Court. I think it's a Herculean task which was done. More than 100 members were appointed to the tribunal, all on account of, and I was at the receiving end from time to time. I never found that these vacancies were not being filled up and had to communicate your lordship's hire, as it were, to the government. And it succeeded to a very, very great extent. And for the first time, we have had the full court of 34 judges sitting at one time itself. And this, I think, is a remarkable achievement for the purpose of the progress of the judiciary and the disposal of cases. I believe that your lordships have made very many speeches, and there are only one or two small extracts which I would like to read from your lordships about the changing face of the judicial function, especially of the Supreme Court. Your lordships had said, till a few decades ago, expectations from a judge were limited to the resolution of a dispute between the parties before the courts. Now every conceivable problem in society is expected to be addressed by the judiciary. People want the judiciary to guide them in every turn of their life, which means that the responsibility which is being placed and which is being accepted by your lordships is great, very great indeed. And again, in regard to fostering social harmony, your lordships in one of the speeches said, in the 21st century, we cannot allow petty, narrow and divisive issues to dictate the human and societal relationship. We have to rise above all the divisive issues to remain focused on human development. A non-inclusive approach is an invitation to disaster. We are losing an intellectual, we are losing an excellent judge, and all is said so far as your lordships are concerned. Your lordships will start a new era in your career, and I have no doubt that it will be as fruitful and as productive as the one which your lordship has just completed on the on the bench of the Supreme Court of India. Thank you.
Lord, I would like to make a very special mention because your lordships have been extremely nice to the bar. So in that sense, it will be a great loss to all of us. We have actually been benefited by your lordship's tenure in so many ways. Not only have your lordships taken care of us as part of the same family, treated us like your own family members, your lordship have also ensured that the prestige of this institution is also maintained, and a clear signal has been given that this court means business, this court will uphold the constitution, this court will ensure that the constitutional rights of the people are never compromised. Lord, I join the learned attorney general. He would be about, I think, 27, your lordship senior, and still working. So it's really sad that we lose our judges at this age, Lord, because when your lordships are really at your prime, and I'm sure easily at least another 5-7 years of good productive work which your lordships at this prime, which your lordships have the experience that your lordships have gained, the country will be missing. But I guess that is destiny, your lordships. We will all have to reconcile to that. And we all, Lord, from the bar, we wish your lordships a very healthy, bright future, And Lord, I also feel that it is just the start of a new innings. And in this new innings, your lordship will have more satisfaction, because as of now, there are a lot of limitations on your lordships in this holding this office. And once those limitations go away, probably, Lord, I feel that your lordship will have a more satisfying next inning. We all, Lord, pray for your lordship's good health and Lord, good future.
Thank you, Lord. We have personally seen. My Lord, we have personally seen, my Lord, that meeting and accepting each and every demand of the park. We have seen, my Lord, that now the waiting area, this utility lounge, even, my Lord, this parking area, then this auditorium. Each and every demand of the bar was accepted, my Lord, by my Lords. And is, we are really grateful that whatever we expect from any Honorable Chief Justice of India, that was fulfilled. Any corner of this premises, we go, we will find somewhere where my Lord's impact is there. We are really grateful and we wish all the best. You are not going to retire. Knowing you well, we feel that you are going to serve in the future and you will contribute more for the nation.
Thank you.
Yeah, brothers, brothers, I complete 50 years in the Supreme Court this year. And I have seen many Chief Justices come, many Chief Justices go. And the learned solicitor mentioned about your biological family and the family at this side. But there's another family that you take care of. That's on that side. The family of judges. You have taken care of that family very well. And I tell you why. When the sea is calm, the ship will sail. But we are going through very turbulent times. And it is difficult for the ship to sail. It is there that this court will remember you for having maintained that balance even in turbulent times. You have ensured that the dignity and the integrity of the court is maintained, that the government is called to answer, that the vision of the nation is kept in mind in the course of your judicial determinations. We thank you for what you have done for all the families that you headed, and we'll remember you for a long, long time. For you have actually collaborated with everyone for the purposes of maintaining what the high standards of the judiciary. And I think the upswing of the court has already started. And I'm sure that your successor will carry it forward. Thank you.
But may I have, with the liberty from my Lord Justice's Lalit and my Lord Justice Kohli, address my Lord the Chief Justice. Lord, if I can say, your lordships have been a citizen's judge. Lord, I speak on behalf of vast multitude of citizens of this country. You stood up for them. You upheld their rights. You upheld the Constitution. When you took over, I wrote that day an article. I was skeptical. I was skeptical after what the court had gone through. I must say, your lordship excelled our expectations. You lived beyond anybody's expectations. You did what is really expected to be done by this court. It was amazing to see. The checks and balance which is required to be kept between judiciary, the executive and the parliament. You did it. And you did it with a smile. You did it with utmost courtesy to the institution, to the lawyers, to everybody who stood up, even parties in person who appeared before you. So I must say, personally speaking, and I speak on behalf of millions and millions of citizens, that your lordships really bless this country with amazing constitutional morality, amazing constitutional ethos, and it will always be remembered for a long time. It's been a privilege for me personally appearing before you, and I really can't hold my emotion, because I genuinely felt when I wrote that article in Indian Express the day you took over that everything was lost. I may be very pessimistic, but I was actually meaning what had happened. And I must say with great sense of satisfaction that your lordships are leaving this court in great hands of Justices Lalit and many judges who are going to follow. And I have no doubt that the kind of atmosphere, the kind of culture, the kind of power that you have given to this institution will continue to be strengthened further. Thank you very, very much. I would I wish you lots of good luck, and I particularly congratulate Mrs. Ramna and family members on this wonderful day, because but for them, you would not have been what you are. Thank you so much.
May I take this opportunity, Your Lordships, to thank Your Lordships, especially from the ladies from the bar, Your Lordships. Your Lordships' inclusive policies have been path-breaking, and in fact, they have brought us members of the bench who are outstanding, well-deserving for a very, very long time. And that trend obviously has to continue. Like Justice Ginsburg had said, that there should be a time when it should no longer be a celebration to invite a woman onto the bench. Maybe 100% women can be constituting benches of the Supreme Court. So I wish to thank Lordships for that trend, which has been initiated and which is, I think, irreversible now, especially in the hands of our incoming Chief Justice. I also want to bring to notice of everyone the role that Chief Justice has played in talking about our judiciary, not just in India, but globally, abroad. And he has actually brought, I think, a large audience to understand that the Indian judiciary is a very strong judiciary, despite having the kind of challenges that it has. It is an extremely strong judiciary, and the trend is certainly going to be following. I welcome Justice Lalit also as our Chief Justice. Very much.
On behalf of the Women Lawyers Association, my lords, I thank Your Lordship for being an excellent human being, my lords, and also taking into account the needs of the women lawyers. In fact, I'm really grateful to Your Lordship for opening and elevating Justice Nidhi Gupta, my lords. She was part of this bar and this court, and it's a first step, my lords. And I request Justice the Lordship Justice Lalit to take over and ensure there's gender parity, my lords, on the bench, at least in tribunals and courts across the country. And I wish you a very happy birthday in advance and retirement with a full life of peace, good health and happiness. And I welcome Justice Lordship Lalit, and I thank Justice Hima Kohli, who's been an inspiration to all women lawyers.
But without repeating anything what my learned colleagues have talked, my lord, we will be failing in our duty. We will not thank Your Lordship, my lord, for uplifting and strengthening, my lord, another facet of judicial justice delivery system, my lord. That is the ADR system, my lord. Your Lordships have, my lord, globally enhanced, my lord, the India's image in ADR justice delivery system, my lord. Especially, my lord, mediation and arbitration. Your Lordships, my lord, showing the opening of another international center in Hyderabad is, my lord, another way forward. And I believe, my lord, just